I know. No.
Yeah.
could run a spot too. I could just kind of. I know, that's why I have to go.
Thank you. Cookies, cookies.
Yeah.
You're all good. Everything? We're gonna. Ready?
You got everything set? Taped, painted, and drawn on? What's going on, Joe?
One more time.
The 80th annual.
Beckies. An end of the year showcase hosted and acted and written by our students. I'm Mr. Beck, and it's been a pleasure working with these talented kids. Part Disney Friar Club roast, part award show, but all collaborated and a showcase of their writing, acting, directing, and general theatricality learned and explored in our theater classes. The program continues to provide a vehicle for novices and experienced alike to work together to demonstrate newly acquired theatrical skills taught via our theater curriculum. We began these awards and program in 2017. We have grown a bit since then with some branding, as you can see, thanks to the support of Dr. Asanso, Dr. Thompson, Dr. Ripley, and the staff administration of this excellent district that strongly supports the arts. When other districts cut theater programs, ours devoted an entire sequence of courses for which I'm grateful to help grow. Yeah. Students can take 4 different levels of theater classes at the high school and work on all aspects of theatrical production to present programs to our Farmingdale community. These students, though often deflate my passion, surprise me daily with their creativity, humor, theatricality. The classes teach skills such as public speaking, collaboration, compromise, self-reflection, and though maybe there's a future Bernadette or Patty, Mandy on stage, maybe a future stage manager, playwright, or dramaturg, but most importantly, students walk away with a stronger sense of self, and that's why we're here. This year we struggled as many arts classes to keep the theater alive through a pandemic, and a hybrid model where students sometimes had to perform behind their computer screens. As you'll see tonight, I think we managed to navigate the experience quite successfully. Perhaps not completely perfectly or without little hits on the head. Right, Audrey? I'm very proud of their individual journey. So here tonight, to get us started, are 2 bright stars from our Theater 1, Period 1 class, Ava Leno and Ava Zimmer.
Almost as bad as when Mr. Beck calls on the students at home.
Theater during a
be inventive. We blurred lines between live performance and video recording. This next commercial parody by Lucia and Sam is an example. Let me just get it. I actually heard that it's supposed to make you younger?
Oh, really?
Yeah. I'm a little curious. I'll be sure to eat these backstage.
I don't know, it's a pretty new product, Ava.
Oh, it'll be fine. Come on.
Okay, don't say I told you so.
Are you sick and tired of your hideous and ugly wrinkles? Do you wake up every day wishing you had that youthful, gorgeous skin back? Well, throw away those other products, because I have just the thing for you. Introducing Age Be Gone, the miracle that'll make your husband love you again. This world-renowned product, known for taking care of those pesky wrinkles and leaves your face looking baby smooth. Just take one pill a day. And voila, no more wrinkles.
Some side effects may include reverse puberty, nausea, chronic fatigue, sudden craving of baby formula. Do not take if you're pregnant, planning to get pregnant, mentally ill, own an iPhone, or have any illness of any sort. Ask your doctor or physician before taking Age Be Gone.
Without using an actual weapon. We'll observe the mock scenario now. Now, my lovely assistant here will play the role of the attacker. Do not worry. Side effects only include hurt feelings and emotional damage. If she wants to keep her job, she'll get over it.
Oh,
what's
okie doke? It's not like it's a
voice.
If
you
want
to turn around, I'll spike in my head.
My voice isn't that bad!
See? Perfectly safe for the user, but horribly debilitating for the assailant. Now it wouldn't be fair if it worked on just one gender. I'll show you it works just as well on everyone else too.
I told them all the people I've met you!
Ladies and gentlemen, it's easy to see how well this product works. Let's go to a word from a satisfied customer.
I love Mad Mad Maze for its compact form and ease to use. I also love using it on my neighbors and other annoying people. Take that, Bill. You're not going to move on my lawn anymore.
And thank you, Natalia, for allowing us to segue into our new line of products. We now present anti-canine spray. And it sprays fluid dog cuts that are sure to make any of man's best friends its most insulted animals. glad we couldn't understand that. It's quite an effective weapon, and quite hilarious, if I do say so myself. You'll buy yours today at $999.99. I said, buy yours today at $999.99. Get your mad, mad mace and spray right in the face. Because we all know words are literally violence. Suck, that's it, I'm done. I'm done with the show. That's it, I'm done. I'm pulling it back.
You know what, Isabella? I think it's pretty perfect that we were picked to present the Best Pantomime Award. I mean, we were both the nominated scenes, you know?
I agree, Makai. I think I should win, though, considering I don't think Mr. Beckies ever heard my real voice before. Since I look, do you have a voice changer?
Who's Mr. Beck again?
Now that I think about it, I don't know, to be honest. I've never seen him in person.
Is he that, disembodied voice I sometimes hear at 7:30?
7:50.
I thought it was like a dream or like a movie without words and props. Oh, maybe that's a pantomime.
Brilliant. Well, here are the nominees for Best Pantomime. Matthew and Kai, Gift Pantomime. Maggie, Griffin, and Kiara, Ghostlight. Mackay, Kylie, Cinderella, and Lucia, JT, Matthew, and Natalia, and me from investor position.
Winner is...
Sure, they go somewhere. Everyone goes somewhere. Now, dear, me and bigger fish to fry. For your pageant tomorrow, I've made alternations to your dress, and I'd like for you to try it on.
Yes, yes. I know how important the pageant is to you, but do they have a home, a place to sleep?
That's not our concern. Not my monkey, not my circus. You get it? Not my monkey. The drummer has a monkey.
Yeah.
All right, then. I think it's time for bed. You need rest for tomorrow's pageant. Come along now.
But Mom, I'm worried.
I'm done talking about this with you, Frances. Good night.
Okay, Mom. Good night.
Her questions unanswered left Frances distraught. With her mind cluttered, no sleep had been caught. As she pondered at midnight, she thought, "Aw, man." And then in her head, she devised a plan. She'd go to her window and peer out to see just where the drummer and his monkey would be.
Is that them on the street? Oh my God, they must be freezing. I have to go, Mom. Maybe now she'll care. Mm-hmm.
Professor.
Princess, why are you waking me up in the middle of the night? I have to wake up very early for work tomorrow.
The street! They sleep on the street. It's dark and cold. We should help them.
Is this about that man and his monkey? Francis, there's no need to worry about them. You have yourself to worry about. It's a very late hour. Go back to your bed.
We should invite them over for dinner and give them something to eat. We can't not do anything for them.
Francis, dear, we're strangers. We don't know who they are, and I will not welcome strangers into our home. Now, you need to get rest for your pageant. I will answer no more of your nonsense tonight.
Mom, please, can't we at least give them some money?
I don't know. Go back to sleep, Francis.
All right, Mom. Good night.
Francis awoke on the day of the pageant, hoping that she would feel better, but she hadn't. Out her window, it glimmered with snow, and for the pageant leader, she needed her bug. Snow boots she slipped on, since it was not summer, but she couldn't help but think about that poor drummer.
Tender glory. It's finally here, in all of its tender glory. Our newest sandwich will have you jumping out of your skin, literally. Handcrafted with the freshest meat. So fresh, no other restaurant dares to take it on. Take a bite into McLovin's brand new, juicy, savory, crispy McHuman sandwich. Ba da ba ba ba!
Comes from penny being cheap,
and more dreadful, something being, oh, what do you say?
Evil!
I watch Wing Tiny Class as an example. Anyways, our actors are here to perform on the premise of what really goes on inside the head of Barbie dolls. Now, without further ado, here's all Brittany, you're a doll. And yes, it's set in that accent. Oh, yes, trigger warnings. Murder, manipulation, fake blood, suicide, transphobia, neglect, and car crashes. All the things that high school teenagers get mad.
So relatable.
Unfortunately, my friends back there are still sick, so we're gonna wait a few minutes. What's your knock-knock joke? We have time.
I would.
Okay. Knock-knock.
Who's there?
Spice.
Spice.
Knock-knock.
Who's there?
Come in. And come in. Come in. And. No, what will I do? What do you want me to do? All right, I've been doing Be Our Guest for the past like 5 years that I've been on the stage. And it feels like it's been 5 years. Because all I've been doing is running out here and going,
life is so unnerving for the servant who's not serving. He's not whole with other souls.
Stop taking my job! That's horrible!
You were over a long time ago, Missy.
Excuse me!
Wow.
I should take
a small bit of possibility.
Another knock-knock joke!
Yeah! Yeah! Knock-knock. The scene! The scene is there!
Oh, look at that, the scene's there! Hey!
Everyone's problems, but I don't know if you
What did you just call me?
Oh, I just meant you probably wouldn't be dedicated to the plan because you think of it as evil.
I can show you evil!
Sorry. Just tell me the plan.
Oh, okay. But like, what if you like come here?
Yeah.
Wait! Okay, so you know I have a lot of professions, correct? Okay, so I have this checklist, just let me go grab it. What are you doing?
Hi! I'm just looking at my past professions. I was a dance teacher, I was a speaker and spy Barbie, I was a math scientist, I even played Maria Summers in Barbie and a Mermaid Tale. Oh, that was one of my favorites. Okay.
What does that say?
What does that say? It's just a bunch of little lines.
It says villain. Can you like not read? But like you're Belle, right? You're
okay, but like that's literally written in
the chat. No, it's not! It's easy!
Whatever! You got the plan? You got your stupid little checklist. Let's just go. And remember, go on my signal. Can your classic P ring remember that?
Sir, yes, sir!
Not a sir. I thought you'd respect my female identity considering you care so much about gender.
Ma'am, yes, ma'am! Control.
bigger things to worry about.
Bigger things? What thing could possibly be bigger than?
Oh no, I killed my best friend. It's my fault that he's dead.
No, Brittany, no! It's not your fault that Luke's dead. It's Belle's. Can't you see that? Do it. Stay up for Lyle. Do it for Luke. Do it for Luke? Yeah, that makes sense. Luke's dead! And I killed him! It's my fault!
So I'll die with him. No.
No!
Aw, oh, man. I wanted to do that one.
Oh, no. Yeah. Let's just ignore the fact that Luke is dead because you made Brittany kill him. Now I know you're odd, strange, peculiar, whatever! But this isn't funny, girl. You killed them.
Okay, but I was merely doing you a favor. You've told me quite a few stories about how he's projected his negative feelings and emotions onto you when playing with you. Putting other people's judgments on you? I remember each and every one of them. It's kind of like what Brittany did.
Not Brittany. Not Luke. Not me. You. You have made me feel so self-conscious about myself since we met 6 years ago. You tormented me on my own comments about my weight and my brains. Well, I'm done.
What are you doing with the car, Harvey?
We don't need any more. They're dead. We don't need the signal.
You don't need that signal anymore. I have my own. Without you.
Oh, no.
No! Always the predator. Now the prey.
No! 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 No!
Helps everyone no matter the situation.
Oh, that's
why we didn't get nominated for this one.
Anyways, the nominees for Real Best Team Player are
Audrey Anderson, Ava Minot, Allison Band, and Makai Jo. And one goes to
speaking of, I gotta head to my ship. I hope everything goes well. call on my watch for an
emergency meeting, and, you know, I thought I could come and, you know, help everybody calm down with my relaxing profession.
What?
All right, I'm off to the studio. Namaste, everybody.
Bye. What is this?
Yeah, I'm just a Stop and Shop grocery bagger.
Oh my god! Look, Chase is getting very aggravated right now, so can't you just take your patrol car and fly up the building and bring the people to safety?
Oh, of course, I'll just like take Danny's private jet.
Wait, hold on, she said private jet? Sky, what are you talking about?
What am I, Kardashian child with a name like that?
Then what is your name?
My name's Gina. My dad is like a criminal justice lawyer. He's working on a case like right now, just down the Grand Street.
Then why are you even here?
Oh, I don't know. I just wanted to do something. My chauffeur won't be here for like another 20 minutes.
Get out of here!
Whatever, you guys are just boring me anyway.
I don't
know. No, what are you doing?
Come on!
No, I'm done! I'm finished! This is over. Gone.
Yeah, it looks like you're gonna have to do this mission by yourselves. On the TV show?
Well, I mean, it was better than the first time she did it.
That's true. Many people in this class do improve.
You know, it would be a challenge to pick the most improved since every single person in this class has improved in some way. Like how Maggie went from, in the beginning of the year, not wanting to do anything, to now writing and directing three different things.
Woo, gave a goal, yo. Went from participating all the time in person to partially participating now and online.
Not sure how that's an improvement, but okay.
Now here's Zayna and Andronicus presenting the Most Improved Award. Hi, I'm Zayna.
I'm Andronicus. I never noticed you, but you ain't that tall.
You should improve your grammar and stop touching the smart board.
Man, this ain't no English class. This a theater class.
ain't a word because ain't in the dictionary. So let's stick with these theater nominees.
Fine, I have to get back to my game of snake anyways. The nominees are...
JT, RPO, Lucia, Essalone, Emily Gaba, Ava Golio, Maggie Seidel.
Now, Max, what if I go to Bloomville
forgotten Bloomville this year, and I think I have something just for you.
Blue Bucks, that's exactly what I wanted. Thank you so much, Santa.
No problem, little girl. Now you have a good night now and a Merry Christmas.
I will, thank you.
Good night.
Let's see them wake up in the morning and see their presents. I hope they're so happy. Look, Pix.
Presents?
Who did this? Santa, he actually came.
Look, they're happy. Let's go see them celebrating. Don't you just love Christmas now?
Yeah, I forgot how magical it is.
Why did you all stop liking Christmas in the first place?
Santa forgot to come to Bloomville one year, and everyone lost hope. We thought he didn't care about us.
Well, I'm glad he came to Bloomville this year. Now let's have some fun and open some presents.
Woohoo! Rudolph the Red Nose Reindeer!
Just a product for you. It's called Collision Cushion. It's a specially designed helmet made to keep you safe while going about your day. You can hardly see it there, so you can wear it anytime and anywhere. Stop paying expensive medical bills from concussions with Collision Cushion. For only a small price of $59.99, you can stop worrying about always getting concussions and start living your life to the fullest. Collision Cushion, available at your local retailers today. For a special TV offer of $9.99, you can get accessories to make your collision cushion fit any occasion, formal, casual, and sporty. But wait, there's more. If you call now, we'll throw in another collision cushion at half price for your clumsy friend. Don't wait. Call 1-800-IT-HURTS or go to your local retailer today.
What a show. You know, didn't you get into concussion actually inspired this?
Actually, Mr. Beck calls the concussion while practicing a death scene.
You know, Mr. Beck has caused a lot of
stress. I took a survey and here's what they said. Kyrie said, incapable of filling out medical forms. Emma said, mental and physical trauma and instability.
Oh, that reminds me. I'm in this next one.
Did you think that survey was about Beck? That was about you. I got a concussion. Even I can recognize that. Come on, Griffin. Well, anyway, here's one of our classes, Penny Dreadful's Rumor, written by Maggie Seidel.
Thank you. trigger warning. The following scenes may contain some material that may be harmful or traumatizing to some audiences. Watch at your own risk. We begin this story in the small town of Lost Springs, Wyoming, at the Depression No More Clinic, founded by Dr. Susie Tuffin. This clinic is 100% anonymous, and many people enjoy coming here to let out all their secrets and just having someone to listen. Right now, Dr. Tuffin is in her office with a local civilian named Rick.
I don't know, it's just been really hard recently. I mean, she died, and it feels like everything is going wrong in my life. I mean, she raised me, and I loved her, maybe more than I even loved my own mother. And her and my grandpa have been married for 60 years, and now he's all alone, and I feel really bad.
I promise you, everything will be okay. It's a part of life. People die and miss them, but we move on and keep them in our hearts.
Thank you so much. I'm going to use the bathroom. I'll be back.
Sounds good.
Shortly after Rick leaves the room, Lucy comes into Dr. Tuffin's office thinking that Rick was done with his session. Little does Dr. Tuffin know, Lucy had a lot to unpack.
Hi, Doc.
I'm not done with my other patients. It'll only be quick, I promise. Fine, but be quick.
So I cheated on my wife. It was 5 years ago, and I regret it a lot. I would have never done it again, but, and I don't want anyone to know, but it's been bugging me, and I just needed to get it off my chest.
While Lucy was confessing this big secret to Dr. Tuffin, Rick was coming back from the bathroom and overheard the conversation. He listened and decided he wanted to tell everybody so people could feel the same pain he was feeling from his grandmother's death.
I don't know what I'd do if she finds out, but I can't let her find out. She's gonna leave me if she... I gotta go. Goodbye.
Okay, goodbye, good luck.
Oh, okay. I'm back.
Okay, what else is on your mind?
Rick went on and on about how terribly hurt he was by his grandmother's passing. But in his head, all he could think about was how excited he was to tell the whole town that somebody was cheating on their wife. Rick was telling everybody after the session, and the next day, all people were talking about was the neighborhood cheater.
Oh God, who could have done this? Who could have told my secret? Oh God, what if she finds out? She's gonna leave me. Who could have done this? It was him! It was that kid from the clinic! He told my secret! He spread it to everyone! I'm gonna take all he has and ruin it!
And that she did. She set her alarm to wake up at 2 o'clock in the morning and set out to kill him.
That's how you stole things, Al?
It's time.
Rick's body has been found. Everybody on Rick's block is wondering what happened to him. As of right now, it is being called a suicide. Apparently, a knife from the new Master Series knife set was used. Local therapists were invited to the scene of the crime to see if they could tell if it was definitely a suicide or not.
Mama, where are you going?
I have to go and do something. Just stay inside and don't let anyone in.
Okay, okay Mama, make sure to be home for dinner.
I will, don't worry. I love you.
I love you too, Mama.
Now, I've seen many suicides in my days, but this one seems different. Whoa, those are the same initials I call my wife. Thank you, Detective. I'm gonna go home. I left my daughter, but I'll look into this later. Ooh. Lou, are you home? Home, I'm home from work.
Oh, I'm in the bathroom. I'll be out in a sec.
Oh, well, I've had a very long night. Work was very stressful. I think I'm just gonna head to bed.
All right, good night.
Good night.
Mama, I've been waiting for you to get home. Come by. So what story are we gonna read tonight? I have Goldilocks and I have the three little bears. What are we gonna read?
No storybook tonight. I had a very long plan. I'm so tired. But I promise I'm gonna read a special story on his birthday.
Okay.
Just get some rest, okay?
Good night, Mama. I love you.
I love you too.
Dr. Tuffin started putting all the pieces together. She realized Rick was the one spreading that someone had cheated, and then just a few days later, he dies and has the same name, Lou, carved into his wrist. There was still one part Dr. Tuffin didn't understand. Why would Lucy kill Rick? And then it hit her. Lucy was the neighborhood cheater, and she wanted revenge on Rick, so she killed him. Dr. Tuffin wants no part in Kirby's life anymore, thinking that Kirby wasn't even her kid, and she was from the affair Lucy so coincidentally had almost 6 years prior.
I'm sorry, Phoebe, but this has to be done.
Mama, what are you doing, Mama?
Please. I'm not your little mama! No, it's okay, Tommy! It's okay!
And the next day...
Hey, Lou, how's work?
Oh, it's fine. It's a bit tired. I'm tired, though. What's for dinner?
Funny you'd ask. I was thinking about having an at-home dinner tonight. What do you want?
Oh, that sounds nice. I think a salad would be all right.
Perfect. I'll have that ready for you when you get home.
All right, I'll come straight home.
Looks like I'm making some Kirby croutons tonight.
Bye.
I'm cheering with the same.
Banter for about six lines.
You're supposed to actually banter with them, so say it.
You guys were not as good as us.
Yeah, sorry, no tea, no shade, no pink lemonade. Y'all,
You know what? All four of you are pretty good. You all get host Beckies. All four. Let us take a brief, about 5-10 minute intermission, and we reset for theater two. So, we're on.
I guess they're not live.
People
watching.
Oh, they did so good.
40 people?
I'm okay. You have no idea.
What is the link?
I was so scared because in all of the rehearsals, it was the best. And I'm like,
you're probably.
I know.
Yes.
I'm so glad.
Get off the podium, please.
Best improv.
I'm not
going to
sit for that.
Yay.
Because everybody's saying it was me. I don't think I was nominated. Mr. Beck, who won best improviser?
Me. Okay.
Okay.
Is it working, Sky, or no?
My Wi-Fi is like so bad.
Because like my parents were like, trying to get onto it because they were like hitting my thing. And like I set up and they were like, it's not bringing me anywhere.
Well, I can't get on the, I can't change the computer right now.
Yeah.
It will be on YouTube eventually.
Okay, yeah.
But let me, hang on, maybe I can do my other computer.
I'll see if they can just search his YouTube channel.
Well, that's yes.
Yeah. I'm going to see if I can call them. I'm going to go into the hallway.
And then we're going to go in like 2 minutes.
Yeah. All right. Thank you, Mr. Brad.
Of course.
I had
drank a
monster.
Why does that make you come back? He can't talk to me anymore. You see this? I'm down. I don't know why it's happening. I'm so much shaking now, and I really
am. Cool. Answer.
But it's great.
Are these garbage back?
The garbage ones, unless they want their names.
Take out the ones.
What do you have? Them are ripped.
Yeah, I'll mine's like ripped. Completely
I'll have
ripped.
Another set of them because I knew
what
that might
the
happen.
What about the script?
Is that for act two or one?
Did you make them hard to open on purpose?
Oh my god.
What? No, they just...
Next year for the Beckies, can I announce someone?
Sure.
Mr. Beck,
you'll actually let me?
Mr. Beck, can I get you on video saying that you'll let me announce an award today?
The cookies are not free, right?
Today?
There's no nuts in them. There was no nuts around. Right?
Wait, where are the cookies? I don't have any cookies.
They're in the hallway.
I have one. They're good.
Mr. Beck, can I get you on video saying that I can announce one of the awards for the Beckies next year?
I know. I don't go on video.
What? What do you mean you don't go on video? You just won on video.
Oh, yeah.
Can we do
it? So is that a yes?
Sure. I want to be in like the...
You're saying you're giving a lot of yeses right now. You must be in a good mood.
If you create something, you can do it.
Right. In the Beckies?
Yeah.
I'm not doing that. But this year we couldn't be in the Beckies.
Wait, this
year.
I'm not doing that.
Next year we could be in the Beckies?
We're doing another Tom Rodrigo song.
Right? Yes, we are. I don't know.
Let's start
was
no one.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, you know who Olivia is?
No.
Okay. Can we show her Olivia?
Yeah, sure.
Olivia Terry?
Yeah. I know, she's so short.
She's a short one.
Not her.
We can do like a nice lyrical dance to Traitor.
Oh my.
We cannot do a lyrical dance.
That's so cool. I am so excited.
For
next year?
Yeah, no, if we make something, we could perform it in the Beckies next year.
Awesome.
We
could all dress up as the different version from her like first three songs that she released.
Please!
license?
Yeah, driver's license days are boom for free.
That'd be so cool.
I could not find my phone
I'm
for the
so
first
tired.
Oh my god, I literally, yesterday in my Snapchat, I just saw pictures of me crying during the virtual Beckies. Cause that was like, it was a year ago from yesterday. That is so funny.
There is so much more production value to this than
oh yeah, exactly.
Have you noticed like how much more production value?
Mr. Beck, I've got...
right here, because I have to...
This, wait, is this being live-streamed?
Yeah, it is.
This being live-streamed? Mr. Beck, I've gotten a text that said that this is amazing, and now I apparently have to go tell Eamon as well.
Mr. Beck, did you see me?
All right.
I'm gonna
Yeah, I know.
That's how it was all year.
I told everybody that Phil was not going to show up. Was that right? Of course I was.
Well, that was the moment. Was he the one there
today,
was he?
No, he was in
the school. Okay.
But either way, I'm from New York.
Well,
I'm assuming that.
Yeah.
I'm assuming, does Wendelin know all the curtain cues, or do I have to run through that?
She's got Alex's script.
So excuse me.
She should, but just again.
Okay, I'll go find if she's still back there.
I don't know where Kyrie is. She stole my joke by coming in the red carpet like
Will the suit just posted an increase for the bus? Hey, I love you. Wilmer.
So, audience to place.
He's still backstage.
I know. What did the ketchup say to the tomato?
Audrey.
You go. What did they say?
Did you see my brother?
I know any brother.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
We need the core five.
The core.
Yes.
The core. The core.
No, it's court five, not court seven. They are not in court five. They decided to sit here.
Oh, that makes sense.
Hi.
What do you think?
To be honest, I'm just here to defend my title as best actor for the third year in a row. What? Molly has just informed me that I won't be eligible for awards tonight.
However, we're here to introduce Theater 2.
What did we do in Theater 2? The audition unit.
Stage combat.
Musical theater.
Improv.
Ugh. Great theater. That was the project we got an 88 on.
Luckily for Mr. Beck, we're no longer there to deflate his passion, as he once said.
However, we are so grateful for Mr. Beck for inflating our passion for theater.
Farmingdale is extremely fortunate to have a theater class with a four-year sequence that offers students the tools necessary to pursue a career in theater after high school.
One of the great benefits of having Mr. Beck's class in the curriculum is that it allows students to be creative in not only writing, but performing in their own scenes.
Needless to say, without Mr. Beck and Theater 2, the both of us would not be where we are today.
Pursuing careers in both production and performance of theater. Thanks, Bessie!
Now, without further ado,
here's Theater 2.
So I had an original introduction written, but I think those two did it better. So without further ado, I bring two other Farmingdale alumni back. Here to do a little intro for us into Theater 2 is John Doty and Ashley the Champs.
Thank you, Mr. Beck. Theater 2 really did help introduce us to topics we worked on in college all this year.
Yes, for me, Theater 2 was a great introduction to beats and scoring, which is what my freshman year really focused on. So Knowing that a line could be broken up into two different intentions and actions was very helpful.
I agree. Good old Stanislavski. I also used the different acting techniques we discussed in a mini project. In college, I selected Uta Hagen in a group project, and it just so happened to be my first year acting teacher taught us from that technique. Also, making a resume in class really helped us too.
Yes. The audition reunit really helped us to be prepared for college, but enough about us. We're really here to celebrate the current Dillers and their work in theater too. So, here to guide us through the night are your hosts,
Trinity, Haley, and Shannon.
Hello, everyone. Hello. Welcome to the fourth annual Beckies Awards.
Hello, everyone. I'm Haley.
I'm Trinity.
And I'm Shannon.
And we're your hosts for the second half of tonight.
Yay!
Anyway, this award will be an assortment of scenes and performances. These scenes and performances were chosen by a class vote of which we thought would be the best to show you tonight. They were also performances that Mr. Beck wouldn't mind being traced back to his name.
And wait, before we get into our first scene and performances, don't we have our first award?
Oh yeah, you're right.
I'm gonna turn it into a frog!
Okay. It's transformation as one transformation in character over the school year, not transforming into an amphibian.
Hey, this is an Hogwarts.
Hey, remember that time Mr. Beck thought we were calling him a purple amphibian?
Yes, that happened.
Honestly, all those memes of him could be considered transformations. Beck transformations. Beckformations!
True. There's Berm and Beckcore and Beckconsul. The list goes on.
I'll thank the Theater One class for those. Anyway. Please welcome Amy McLaughlin and Jenna Hamelman's video to the stage.
Gee, Amen. It really stinks that I haven't been to school at all this year. I mean, I didn't even get to see Mr. Beck's cat sweater this Christmas.
Too bad.
And you know, the worst thing of all is that I don't get to go to the Beckies this year.
Well, maybe you'll be able to participate in some way. Oh, look, a caterpillar.
A caterpillar? Oh, silly Eamon. That's not a caterpillar. That's a butterfly.
A butterfly?
A butterfly. A butterfly is a caterpillar that went through a transformation. Can you say transformation?
Transformation! Transformation!
Good job!
This butterfly went through a transformation, just like our nominees. Oh no, the butterfly just flew away.
Ava, you better go catch it.
I sure will.
Sure? Yeah, a cat.
We would like to welcome to the stage our performers, a cat. I mean, Gabby Stein and Skylar Studder, presenting their scene, Quarantine with Humans.
When is the human going back to work?
Just saying, I understand.
Skipper is dead.
I've not quit you. No, but you started drinking.
You think so too?
Shh. Just go away. We just broke a glass.
You think so?
so too. You think so too. You think me and Skipper did sodomy together. That's what you think.
I don't know nothing. I'm simply telling you what I heard. You shut your mouth now. Shut your mouth, goddammit!
That's what you think!
I'm like that.
I
think you have some of his talent and some of his tendency towards instability.
I can't believe this.
Phoebe, just calm down. It's fine.
Go to hell!
Calm down.
I hate you! I hate you!
Award is our best comedic performance award.
They should give this award to us. Look how funny we are. We're literally just funny just because of how much of a mess we are. And because of the fact that we start off every single sentence with the word, anyways.
I hate us.
I love us.
Anyways.
Please welcome Aiden to the stage to present the Best Comedic Performance Award.
Woo! Yeah.
Well, good evening, everybody. Now that was called a comedic swing. A term I didn't know existed until this year. Thanks, Mr. Beck.
You're welcome.
But I would first like to start off with saying that I opened my envelope backstage. Because of the events. I did not look, but I did open it. Because of the events that have occurred tonight, that was comedy. You know, a good comedic performance is a hard thing to come by now. I mean, just look at the new SNL skits and you'll find out. And that brings me to the nominees for Best Comedic Performance. Hayley Batista, Ryan Marbit, Carly Payne, and Gabriella Stein. And the winner is... Carly Payne!
Trin and Shannon! Not me, because
Me and Eamon had a seed plant from last year, and then our joke got old, and then no one got it. But anyways,
I forgot to mention that it also features our queen, Jenny.
Yeah, my mom's in it. Shout out to my mom! And
did a live scene or something over the meet, but because we're so cool and quirky and awesome, we made a video, so.
Anyway, so, let's put this cake away so it's perfect for tomorrow's makeup. Perfect, follow me, I'll show you the perfect spot.
Oh no, I hope I don't fall.
Never mind,
Speaking of funny, remember when Mr. Beck forgot to add the best duo award to the show structure?
Mm-hmm.
Well, guess what?
What?
He put it here. Right after the other award.
Oh, that makes total sense.
Well, anyways, we would like to welcome Zipporah to the stage.
Man, duels are great.
Ain't that right, Casper?
I guess we can try and name a better duo than me and loneliness. Go ahead, I'll wait. Like there are some competitors, because here are your nominees for best duo: Rebecca and Mia, Aiden and Eamon, Trinity and Shannon, and Mia and Wendell.
All right.
Come on, you got it.
Hey!
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 Did that
make?
And the winner is Rebecca and Mia.
Arrange a sort of deal to smooth things over.
your mouth shut. Do you have a deal?
We have a deal.
I had to pick the two gentlemen who worked really hard to perfect their scene.
Our very own host, Haley Matisse, opening scene called 30 Seconds.
Shouldn't be dressing like that. You know what happens to them when they do?
No.
They become a distraction to the other boys in the building. They're just trying to get an education, and it's your fault!
It's not anything racist, huh?
Do not interrupt me! Look, it is your sole purpose to make the lives easier of your peers and your teachers. And if you're going around showing your private parts to the world, you're not doing your job, and I'm gonna have to ask you to cover up.
How am I supposed to focus in class wearing long sleeves and long pants that we don't have jewels?
Well, that's not my problem, quite frankly.
Then, if you're criticizing what I wear, it should be your job to tell me what I
should wear. It is not your place to sass me, young lady.
Hey, should I come back later? I'm sorry.
There's my favorite track star! Hey, buddy, you know, I saw the meet a couple weeks ago. That was some pretty impressive stuff.
New tonight. Man attacked outside of a Walmart. 46-year-old Linda James attacks a 23-year-old male outside of a Walmart parking lot. Police are classifying this attack as a hate crime, as a suspect was seen wearing a rainbow pride shirt.
Sorry.
moving on. Now we have our next award for best playwright.
But the presenters didn't send in their video.
Yeah.
So now we have to present.
Yeah. Yay.
And the nominees for the best playwright are Trinity Gavino, Jenna Heimerman, Carly Payne, and Gabby Stein.
And the winner.
The winner is.
So in the course, it would be remiss not to thank Lucia for best commercial and her grandma. So her grandma really should get this award. And I wanted to give someone we're calling the quarantine award, because I think even despite the meets, they were always positive, they always paid attention, mostly, and just really were still there despite being home all the time. So Skylar, you're getting the quarantine award. And then the last thing is, we had the Nassau Community College monologue competition. And this year, we did really well. We had three winners. Basically, we did 50%, which is not bad at all, out of other schools. We were up against some top schools like Long Island School of the Arts, and yet we still had three winners, which is really good. So I want to give the trophy. So Aiden Kelly got second place. Nova Bowling got second place. That's yours. You're welcome. And then Emma got third place in 11. Two seniors really this year. Next year we're gonna have a boatload, but this year we only have two. So Aiden Kelly and Zephora Muse, please come out if you can hear me. Yes. Oh, Matthew. Yes, Matthew. I had that multiple years. That's why they're in my mind.
Wow.
I can make mistakes too. I guess I've been becked. All right. All right. So Matthew, join them. Yeah, stay down here because then you can mic the panel. So what I want to say is, obviously, something very brief about each of them, and then the three of you together are going to light this center candle. So it's a candle for good luck to where you're going off to. I know at least two of you are going to schools for the arts. Zephora, what are you going for?
Psychology.
So you're all going off to wonderful, hopefully, careers in college.
He's going to be Patrick Starr.
Yes. Yeah! So as I was saying, so Zephora has come a long way. She joined us last year, and really in 2 years, what a blossoming I've seen in her personality. I think anybody in her classes can attest to see how she's grown these last 2 years. What can I say about Aiden? Everybody knows Aiden, right?
Yeah!
This man has, from his time with his little mustache in The Matchmaker, grown all the way this year to Dallas and Outsiders, and then this year to the Foreman of the Jury, has been somebody who, with all my heart, I really think can make it if he continues to grind, because notice the grindstone really worked. So, clearly I keep in touch with those who I cherish, John and Ashley, Vitaly and Molly, as you see, or we're all sending their little videos. I expect the same to be from you. And then Matthew, who is new to the school this year.
Who was also forgotten.
Bring it up. So I only forgot because I can't get Beauty and the Beast out of my head because of you, so it's all your fault. I was trying to push it to the side. But no, since Matthew even this year too, you don't know how many times we worked the Mad Mad Mace commercial.
Oh my God.
He was a good sport about it, so for that reason he's going to five towns next year and hopefully on to another theatrical life. So for the three of you, I want to light this candle for you, and then you're going to light the center candle together. Let's move this prop.
Even the lighter's green.
I just want to wish you all the best of luck, and I know you are all going on to really good things. So the three of you, come grab this candle here. Let's hope the fire alarm doesn't go off, and then light that middle.
I don't remove it. I don't think this is COVID safe.
That's all right.
No.
Thank you all for making this hard year something really special. I hope you all enjoyed what we had here for you tonight. You really deserved it. You've done a great job this year. You stuck with it despite being online in many cases. And as I said this morning for period one, I think you've all really grown as a family. I love you all. Have a great night. We're done.
That's the biggest things I could ever ask.
Absolutely.
Me on the other
tired.
My wife is scared up in the corner now.
But believe it or not, this man in this class has helped me so much. I remember that day. He told me, it was a Tuesday, I remember, he said, you should join theater class. And I was like, why?
I get that reaction a lot.
But I'm so thankful, and I'm pretty sure everyone is thankful for having a teacher like you. I'm pretty sure you've been like the reason many people like to come to school. Like for me, like theater class is the only class I have in this one.
Now everyone, on three, we love you, Mr. Beck. Ready? One.